coming back at you with a tutorial that I'm going to be doing for the baby crib. So basically, this is just how I decorated it. It's like an under the sea type of thing. And so I just put one of her drawers there, one of the other drawers there, and I'm just going to go up close on it. I just picture this as Jesus, love of my soul, and then I have all the different sea animals on this net, like it's caught in the net. And I have her name, of course, Olivia. I made this crib mold. I did not do a tutorial on it, but if you have any questions or details about this, just let me know. Leave a comment down below, and I'll be sure to answer them. And yes, so this is the baby crib. This is the baby crib. Sequence pillow. Well, the heart-shaped sequence pillow I got brand new from the thrift store, my local thrift store. And the two other sequence pillows were those pillows that I made in that tutorial. Be sure to check that out. It's a couple videos back from months ago, I guess. And so that crab pillow actually came with the crib bedding that my husband purchased. So yeah, this is just how it looks. And basically this video that I'm going to be making, well, those are diapers under the bed. I had to store them there as well. Pretty short line though. But I'm just going to be doing a tutorial on the tool that I'm doing down here. So just stay tuned. If you want to see how I'm doing this, just stay tuned. I'm making a tool, tutu crib skirt. So just keep watching and you'll see how it goes. Okay, so I'm back. It may be a little noisy because I have two of my boys here at home with me and the other one is at school. So it's going to be noisy. You may hear cartoons in the background and whatever they decide to make the noise that they make feel here. So. Basically, I'm just going to get my tool. I got this tool brand new from my thrift store. So, just going to unwrap maybe like this much. Let me see if I can get a better. Just going to unwrap this much. And so, basically what I'm going to do, I'm going to take my scissors. And I'm just going to cut it. Doesn't have to be perfect. But you see how this one is rigid? I'm gonna have to clean that up with my scissors. So I'm just gonna cut that rigid part off. That's really messed up. The scissors are so dull, so please bear with me. So I'm gonna take my tool, and what I'm gonna do is this. Fold it like this, like long ways. You just fold it like that. And you're gonna take the tool just like how you're holding it. You're gonna put it over one part. You're gonna open the loop. And you're gonna pull this through the loop. And you're gonna fluff it out. That's what you're gonna do. Now, I'm trying to figure out if I can probably possibly put some tool in this gap, but if I can't, I'm gonna try to attempt. I don't know how I'm gonna do that yet, but I'm gonna try to improvise and see how I can get in there. Put that back inside. So. Gonna cut that tutu like I've been doing. Gonna make a clean cut and I'm gonna take it again. I don't know how I'm gonna do this part because I never did that part before, but I think I'm just gonna fold it the way I did before. I think I'm gonna come around instead. I think I'm gonna loop it, come around, pull it through. So nice, so maybe I'll try this one. I don't like that either. I think I'm just gonna leave that for later. Take this part, And I think I'm going to probably put more than one piece on each bar, or each spacing. This one here, so I'm going to cut it as clean as possible. And I'm just going to keep doing the same process. Repeat the process over and over again. And we're just going to keep doing this. So, it's going to pull through. Yeah, I like this better because it's way much fuller. Way much fuller, and that's what I needed. Since one can't go right here, just double it up. If you have a crevice like this where one can't go on here, this particular bar, because this has made, just double it up on each spacing. Put two pieces of tulle on each spacing. And I'm sorry if my video's not good quality right now. I am currently, I just turned 37 weeks today, so I'm exhausted and I have not gotten any rest in a long time, so I'm trying to do this video as best as I can, but I ain't gonna lie, I am tired, so you have to bear with me. And I feel like it's coming along pretty well. It's not perfect, but it's good enough to me. So as we're moving along, I'm just going to keep showing you. Make that loop. Got your tool. At least have a piece that's like about this long. It's not even that long of a piece. So, and right here, I'm going to take that tool, fold it like this, and with this little loop part, I'm going to have that loop right there. I'm going to place the loop through here while still holding it. Gonna place the loop right there, bring the loop down like this, put the tool through, and pull, fluff it out. Fluff it out. And remember to double it up on each space. So I'm going to put another one in that same space. I'm going to open up that loop, pull it through, and I'm going to fluff it out. Fluff it out. And don't worry if it's uneven, because mine is a little bit uneven. I had to store all them diapers underneath the crib, and I just didn't want them to be exposed right there. So, this is a tool here. I bought this tool because my husband did this before with some white tool. We didn't have a crib bedding at the time, but we did put a white tool on the baby bed, and my 1-year-old destroyed it. He was upset because this used to be his crib, and now he has a toddler bed, but he wants to still be the baby, so he was upset. He ripped all the tool off, pulled it all off, so. But now he's well adjusted. Clean it up. Make sure you 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 clean it up. So, I'm just gonna keep going. But basically, yes, I'm 37 weeks today. Monday, I tried to get my membrane stripped, but it didn't work because my cervix decides to be so far up that you can't reach the membrane. So, I think I'm just going to have to do it. So, yeah. I like that's what's going to happen. Moving along. Okay, some more tool, and then we're going to cut. Yes, I'm just gonna have this little girl. First girl after three boys. I'm shocked. I'm thankful. But I am shocked. No spitting, Josiah. Cut it out. So as I keep going, have a baby soon and everything goes all well. Okay, I'm almost done with the front. But I will have some more tutorials up posted, hopefully, soon. I don't want to make a promise to you all and then it just, you know, just goes bad. Because I am supposed to be having this little baby and I know I'm going to become very busy. But I will have a tutorial today on what I'm packing in both of my hospital bags. Someone requested that I do that, so I'm trying to keep my promises to all my subscribers. So forgive me if I've been sluggish with it all. I'm just really exhausted. I'm a really busy person, so it just has to be the right time for me to just do this thing. It's pretty hard right now. And I'm exhausted every day before taking my kids to school, so yeah. It's beautiful. My husband, they're trying to make it easier for me. So, we just have that last little part. up, bend it out.
With my boys, and I have something with my husband. We're just trying to get all this other stuff out the way. Stop it, Josiah. Take the piece of tool, loop it like this, just like that, take the loop, put the loop through it, the end part through it, to both of them parts through it, pull it through, and then just have to easily put those. Ow! Ow! Ow!
Joshua and Josiah cut it out. That's enough. It's just a dark day. So yes, this is how it's looking. I have to cut it evenly. So I'm gonna fix my camera so you guys can see. Josiah, would you cut it out? So basically, this is what it looks like. If you have any questions, I know it's a little bit not really a good tutorial, but if you have any questions, please comment down below. If you want me to redo this tutorial, or if you want me to redo this tutorial, please let me know. I totally understand. The results of it, I think I might cut it a little bit short. Wait, to be
be a little bit better. There we go. This way, though. Okay, that chop's still too long. That was better. Just have to fluff them out. This is the end result of the first part. I might do a second part too, but I'm probably not able to right now. But if I'm not, if you need any help or any questions, or just comment down below. But this is how it looks. And I believe this tool is like a lavender kind of purplish pink, I guess. So yes, this is it. Thank you guys for tuning in. Hope you guys have a blessed day. Bye.